All right, it is that time of the year where we are getting a new main version update for Genshin. Let's see what 4.0 has going on. It's an hour-long freaking special program. So hopefully there's going to be lots of good stuff to show off. I'm starting off with some kind of a magic show. That was a nice transition. Okay. All right, the 4.0 trailer.
I'm not sure exactly when it began.
The new main version trailers are always top notch.
The people will all be dissolved into the waters, and only the Hydro Archon will remain, weeping on her throne.
Well, that doesn't sound good.
Welcome you to the nation of Hydro, and acknowledge the value and significance of your trip.
Now, wow. Okay, that's looking nice. In this. I have like
in
waterway
opinion,
transportation
do you think it's
things
right to
going
treat
on.
A trial like it's an opera?
To the people of Fontaine, the line between a trial and a performance can be a little blurred. Welcome, one and all, to the Opera Epicles. Watch carefully now. Blink and you might miss it.
Okay, Lenny, 5-star. Okay. He throws cards. He's got a bow.
Step right up.
I feel like they should have just made him a catalyst user and he would just throw
Lynette.
Cards for all his
will
attacks.
Be working as my wonderful assistant.
Ta-da.
Oh, Lynette's only a 4-star. She got the short end of the stick.
Step on up.
Ooh, that was cool.
Let the magic begin.
That reminded me of Yavon's ability.
Here comes the finale.
What the heck? Is that his first? You summon a freaking was it a cat in a hat? Who left that painting easel out there? Ooh, what is this guy? Oh. I already moved past it.
I want to spend some time at the bottom of the sea in peace.
It's the diver character. Fremenet. Also a 4-star. Using the bell? Is this gonna be a character who actually wants to use the bell? Like a diver helmet.
If you look up at the sky from far enough underwater, even the sun is soft on the ice. These fossils are all that's left of these beautiful creatures. I wonder how long before the rest of the world becomes part of this underwater museum, too.
Interesting.
I'm.
So.
Wait. Who am I?
Traveler? The heck is this?
The water is gradually swallowing our memories.
Robot dancers or something?
It won't be long before it swallows us.
We've been trying to find out how the Oratrice operates. We want to know why it has a consciousness. Why can it deliver sentences accurately?
What's an Oratrice?
It's raining.
We must know all we can about this nation's secrets in order to deal with that prophesized crisis.
Is this part of the show?
You gotta be kidding!
What the heck?
What happened?
Did she just vanish?
Charges have now
leaving
been
her clothes behind?
And as such, a trial is in order. Therefore, you would be wise to tell everything you know and seek the protection
of the gods.
Is that the
lady with the gun?
Dear God, it's a whole army of Gardamax.
I believe this is indeed the finale.
looking like we're going to be working with the Umbrella Lady.
Turning a blind eye to the suffering of the people.
In your eyes, the value of the human life is nothing compared to those cold laws you hold so dear.
Oh, Tartaglia's here too?
So this is how justice is done in Fontaine. What a joke. You've got your rules. Well, I've got mine too!
You just busting in to interrupt a freaking court session? Nothing from Arlecchino. The underwater exploration. I imagine we're going to learn a lot about that here. Tell me I can do it with any character I want. If you say I have to be the traveler, this is going to be terrible. Okay, they dived in with Lynette. So you don't have to be the traveler. And you can still swap underwater? Okay, we're off to a good start here. Yeah, the underwater is more expansive than I was thinking, just looking at this.
There's
an oxygen bar? Where's that at? I didn't even see it. Oh, they're saying it doesn't have that. Okay. Remove stamina consumption. In waters where players can dive. Okay. So you'll still have stamina in all the other waters in the game.
Okay.
Okay, this seems good.
移动期间，玩家也可以在洋流中自由地调整位置和视角， 观看沿途的风景， 其实是一个观光的一个好办法。
So, you know, they've even put in methods for you to, like, move around more quickly.
This
is actually looking pretty fun. Ooh, what the heck is going on here? Floating bodies of water? You can just glide into them? And you transition straight into swimming. Oh, you can just, like, jump out?
Okay,
this is seeming really cool.
设计的相对的比较通畅，比较宽敞。 那请大家也不用担心在其中探索会迷路。 在封丹水下的设计预期中呢，我们不太希望出现这样的情况。 所以封丹水大部分的水下内容的呈现效果都非常通透，玩家可以时刻观察到海面上透下的光线，水底的光源也十分充足。
Underwater lighting is sufficient. Yeah, it's important that we can see clearly. Okay, one thing I will say about this is I really hope that to go with this underwater exploration, that they increase the camera sensitivity for controllers, especially the vertical camera movement, because it is painfully slow. Hopefully that's turned up for this. So how does combat underwater work?
That's easy.
Just take electro characters. You're good to go.
简约但互动性良好的水下战斗规则。
Just let me swim with Cookie. Everything will die.
玩家可以从水中特定的远海异种生物身上获得与之对应的能力，用来对抗敌人和进行解谜。比如有一种远海异种叫做重甲蟹。
So there's things you interact with that give you different abilities.
玩家可以通过长按来发动格挡效果。 除了获得护盾之外呢，还能反弹敌方的。
So all your underwater abilities will be from these, and you don't use any of your character's regular abilities, I'm guessing.
其实，在封丹的序曲 PV
发布的时候，其实是封丹本土角色的一种特殊性质，我们称它为史基利，分为荒性和盲性两种对立的特性。荒性和盲性的史基利相遇的时候会触发湮灭，产生能量。
Annihilation，
其实是利用了这个特性为城市里的各种设备功能。 玩家可以通过利用部分枫丹角色的实际利益追击效果来干扰他们的功能系统，逼迫他们退出这些模式，采取其他的形式对抗玩家。
That makes it sound like combat in Fontaine is going to suck if you don't have any Fontaine characters. Is Hydro Traveler going to be able to do this stuff? What the heck is this? This isn't Genshin Impact? What am I watching, some reality show? Oh, we're watching a show about a guy who plays Genshin Impact. Man, get that crap off your phone. Go get a computer. Man, if these people were real Genshin players, they would have pre-installed this stuff 2 days ago. What are you doing? Stop that. Oh, great. It's somehow a pressure plate. You just vandalized that bus. Man, they're really going in on this freaking magician stuff just because Linny and Lynette are magicians. Oh, we're adjusting the time now? Oh yeah, just fast forward your download speed. Only we could do that in IRL. They're like, oh, this download's gonna take 3 hours? Yeah, let me just fast forward real quick. Aw, oh, that's so unrealistic. Dude, you gotta wait like another hour for it to verify resources or whatever. Nah, you're not done yet. You can't play the game. It's gotta verify file integrity, that's what it is. Pyro bow user. It feels kind of dumb that he shoots a bow when he could just be throwing cards the whole time. So you're gonna have a passive talent that's for underwater stuff?
That
makes sense. And put that bow in. Throw your cards.
Now disappear! Let's get this show on the road!
His burst is funny, though. I like that.
Seems Linny is saying some strange things again. It's really worrying.
Wait, so she has, like, cat ears or whatever, right? Do the other siblings have animal ears? Oh, she has a tail, too. Her siblings didn't have ears or tail, did they?
It's easy to fix a machine when you know how it's built and how it works. But people...
Yeah, he definitely doesn't.
They're much more difficult.
I'd have to look at Linny again.
Ooh.
Okay. I like this. Tartaglia. Okay, that makes sense because Tartaglia is going to be in the story. And Fremenet's on that banner. Okay. This Navi of the long blonde hair. Is that the Umbrella Lady? Navia, yeah. Umbrella Lady. I guess I can stop calling her that.
行事作风更是相当不拘一格。在4.0版本的魔神任务中，我们将与她。
Yeah, now that I see her kind of like more in detail, I like her design a lot more.
身手不凡的决斗代理人克洛林德，他不仅是公子达达利亚渴望去切磋过招的对手， 也和纳维亚之间有着某种复杂的联系。
Okay, so、至于严肃公正的
最高审判官纳维莱特，大伟哥刚刚就很在意的性格跳脱的水神弗宁娜，还有提前和大家见过面、到处追求着大新闻的蒸汽鸟报记者夏洛蒂，都将在四点零版本的《
Charlotte's not one of the first characters we're getting.
除了上述提到的角色之外呢，我们在序曲 PV 至中目的欢宴中出场的其他人物呢，也将在后续版本中陆续与大家见面。
哦、oh, ，Tell me about Arlecchino. Tell me she's coming.
这三个版本都有魔神任务吗？
是的，枫丹的主线故事将从四点零贯穿到四点二。
Okay, so、version 4.0 to 4.2. It's like scenario.
他们希望赋予这些机器艺术的价值。
Wait, is this a boss?
这两台表演用的舞蹈机器人便诞生了。不过，机械师梅亚德在接手后，又将他们改造成了战斗用机器人。现在，帮助机械师收集战斗数据，成为了他们的主要功能。
It's a duo of dancing robot bosses. Okay,
that's
interesting.
结合花样滑冰的动作，
看他的身形啊，十分威猛呀。背后好像还有一个小
火山。Some kind of big fire crab thing.
刚才看到的这种远海异种，在外形上差别很大。
嗯，确实。铁甲熔火帝王的性格暴躁易怒，攻击也。
I wonder if they're going to do any underwater bosses.
他背部的小火山其实是可以发射火球的火炮，想必现在的他正在等待着一位值得挑战的对手来。
在本次机书巧物前哨战的过程中啊，为了展现出决斗代理人级别的本领
，Everyone gets a free Bennett.
三个实验，他们
just in case you wanted C6, you know, here's a Bennett.
来换取相应的物资作为报酬。第一个实验是跑酷玩法，湍流急行冲锋赛。在枫丹地区啊，我们有着广阔的水下区域，旅行者在水下可以。
I think having events for the underwater gameplay is a good idea.
同时需要躲避水下的各种障碍而完成关
卡挑战。Like introduce.
相信旅行者们可以沿途欣赏到
the underwater stuff and get people doing stuff with it.
挑战玩法还会有显示题。
This is basically an event that's like go learn all of the material locations.
这个或者生物来完成委托。如果旅行者呢对枫丹还不太熟悉，
暂时找不到需要进入的事物，
可以前往活动界面上的推荐的地方去寻找哦。
好耶，是我最喜欢的拍照活动了。
除此之外
oh, come on, stop lying. That's no one's favorite.
战斗挑战活动，那就是在 4.0 版本更新后，当旅行者的冒险等级达到
25
级之后，就可以在活动面板通过活动
at AR25
不落幕，免费领取四星角色林尼特。
So I guess everyone will just have a Fontaine character, even if Hydro Traveler doesn't work. With their unique energy mechanic, everyone will at least have Lynette.
还会同时4.0版本中还会有全新的角色装备带给大家。
The new weapons, what the Battle Pass weapons?
12把全新武器。
12 new weapons.
Okay,
yeah, we have the Gacha Bow. Don't care. Oh yeah, new forgeables. Like, I didn't even think about that. Of course, there's new forgeables, new Battle Pass.
其中啊，
the heck was that?
5把锻造武器的图纸。大家可以在枫丹城的铁匠铺找到伊斯带来兑换。另外啊，此次新增加的5把四星的巨型武器会进入30级巨型的奖励箱中。在添加新巨型武器的同时啊，我们也保留了以前旧的巨型武器。
Okay, that's good.
那这样的话，旅行者就可以在新旧共10把武器当中啊自由选择了。与此同时啊，我们也推出了两套全新圣遗物。烛影猎人与黄金剧团、
okay.
旅行者们可以通过挑战全新的祝圣秘境最祸的周末来获取。
Are you going to tell us what they do? Or not?
4.0 版本还有什么系统优化与更新方面的消息可以告诉我吗？
System optimization and upgrades, okay.
那既然是年度版本的开端啊，我们必然会着重解决于现在最困扰玩家的问题，以及
优化issues we're most concerned about. Like endgame content?
这次啊，给大家带来的是分层地图和配对界面的优化。另外啊，我们的七圣召唤
增加了观战模式。
4.0 版本将会实装分层地图功能，我们希望它能够提升玩家的探索体验。当旅行者们进入有分层地图的区域时，小地图啊就会自动切换为显示分层地图的样子。
Okay.
当回到提瓦特大地图界面时，小地图显示就变回我们熟悉的老样子。
So we have underground maps. Finally, they should have had straight from 3.0, to be honest.
旅行者们打开分层地图
，It took them way too long to add this.
同层点的角标，哎，还是挺方便的。
嗯，这是一个很实用的功能啊。
哎，是的，除了 4.0 即将上线的新地区会实装分层地图功能以外啊。我们还会对已经上线的部分区域更新分层地图，
帮助玩家。Sumeru freaking needed underground maps badly.
也就是说，之前像赤王林或是荒海这样的地方，我们也能在4.0更新后看到他们的分层地图了。
嗯，没错。啊，另外啊， 我们也对角色配对界面进行了全面的改造。
Upgraded the party setup screen.
版本后，配对界面会以更加动态的方式。
Have a more lively look.
我们为每一位角色都重新设计了入队和换位的效果。
哎，等一下。这真的是每名角色在配对界面都有独特的出场演出吗？
完全没错。Cool, I guess, but like this is super minor.
独特的动画。我们在调整角色在队伍中的顺序的时候啊，也可以看到他们充满个性的演出。哎，值得一提的是啊，配对界面的背景还有许多种。
Be different backgrounds. Background will change.
配对界面背景啊还会随之切
换。According to locations where traveler enters party setup.
就等待旅行者们在 4.0 版本后自己去发现了。
哇，雷电将军的配对效果好酷啊！
是的，那最后啊，大家很关心的七圣召唤的
观战功能也会在
版本正式上线。
Pretty much.
玩家可以通过好友界面或者联机界面，选择观战自己的好友或者联机队友正在进行的七圣召唤对局。如果玩家和对战双方均在同一个大世界啊，还支持以裁判视角来进行观战，掌控全局。
So you can spectate matches.
希望其他人观战自己的
对局。But we still don't have a chat box.
七圣召唤的局内设置当中进行设置哦。
哎，不错。
Like, can we freaking use the damn chat function of the game when we're in the TCG? You know, something really basic and simple would be really nice. Fucking, they add a whole new thing with spectating before they just enable the chat box during duels. Like, come on.
好了，我们今天的前瞻节目到这里也接近尾声了。
Okay.
我们的 4.0 版本。也将在八月十六日
，will be available August 16th, okay.
见面。感谢大家一直以来对原神的支持，祝各位的枫丹之旅也充满乐趣。See you in Fontaine, travelers.
Wait, did you just say that in English?
乐趣。See you in Fontaine, travelers.
Okay, so that was the 4.0 special program, and I think Fontaine's looking pretty good. Personally, I am super excited to dive it into, no pun intended, dive into all of this underwater stuff. I think it looks great. I think they did a great job designing this. The only concern I have is like camera sensitivity with how much you're probably going to need to like look around, especially like looking up and down. I was really worried about the whole, you know, like only being able to use the Traveler underwater or something, especially if it was like specifically Hydro Traveler. I came into this worried that like we would only be able to dive with Hydro Traveler and that would be it, because you would use Hydro Traveler's abilities underwater. But as it turns out, you can just use any character. You can even switch while underwater. And there's no stamina, at least not like a normal stamina bar while you're underwater. No breath meter or anything. So you can just freely swim around as much as you want. And it seems great. You know, they even have stuff to kind of like make you go faster, speed up your underwater traversal. So I think they did a great job with this, from what I've seen. Heck, they even have these freaking, like, floating water cubes. Reminds me of stuff you'd see in freaking Minecraft, people doing, building, like, crazy water cubes up in the air. Yeah, this is looking really cool. Can't wait to get into this stuff. It seems like we might not be getting that much story, because I think they only mentioned Act 1. I don't know how many acts there will be in total, but you know, it's going to be spread over 3.0, 3.1, and 3.2. Sorry, 4. 4.0, 1 and 2. But we're only getting an Act 1 for 4.0. And they didn't show Arlecchino at all, so she's probably not going to be involved in the story yet. I am really curious to see what this like unique energy system the Fontaine characters have is. Like, I didn't really understand what it was from what they were saying in the special program. It's something unique to Fontaine characters. Now, luckily, we're all getting Lynette for free. I'm curious as to whether Hydro Traveler will be able to do the same things, but I don't think he will, because I feel like they would have mentioned that if the Traveler would be able to. I look forward to seeing what all the new weapons and artifacts do. They didn't talk about those at all in detail. And they normally don't for weapons, but they usually show the details of artifact sets, of new artifact sets, but they didn't do that this time for whatever reason. They showed them, they gave us the name of the sets, but they didn't give us the details, which is a little annoying. So I'll have to freaking wait until this actually comes out to see what they do. The new bosses looked cool. I hope they're fun to fight. this new like party select stuff they got going on, I mean, this is cool, I guess. It doesn't really, it does nothing gameplay wise, but it is like a cool, like nice level of polish, I guess, an extra level of polish for the game. Anyways, I think that's all I have to say for this special program. So until 4.0 comes out and I do some gameplay of it, I will see you later.